Hello students, we are going to continue with our fifth chapter, and today's topic is concept of training and importance of training, right? See, basically training, that means what? Training, that means to give the modern knowledge, or we can say that, you know, enhancement of a skill by providing theoretical or practical knowledge, right? We have completed till, you know, that in the process of staffing till the selection, recruitment that is done, selection done, and then when the particular employee is going to enter into the company, enter into the business unit, that person need to get some sort of training, right? Training, it can be in the terms of job, in the terms of, you know, personality development or anything, right? And training, it is required at every level of management, whether it is top, middle or a bottom, okay, right? So let us understand the concept of training, right? See, however the person, that is, he is efficient or whatever the things, but if he is lacking of a skill, experience, then that person is not going to give their 100%, okay? So that, you know, that what is the training? Training is the process of imparting the theoretical and the practical knowledge, right? For what purpose? For the enhancement of the skill, for enhancement of the knowledge, right? And training, it can be related to work or it can be for the personality development, okay, right? And see, training, it is a process of for a short time, that is, it is a temporary process, like, you know, that training, it can be for 1 day, 2 day, or max 3 days, not more than that, right? Depending on the work, depending on the job, okay, by which kind of training that is going to be required, at what kind of a level, that suppose the bottom level people, they are going to need the training for a sort of period of time, while the managerial levels, those who are, you know, those who are involved in the intellectual process, they are going to get that particular training for a longer period of time, right? Because their intellectual skills that need to be developed, so maximum efforts that will be required, right? And basically, you know, that specifically training, that is for whom? That is for the bottom level of workers. Middle level and top level, they are going to get their development. That is the next topic that we are going to see. Okay, right? So basically this training, that is, it is a basic level thing, and it is for whom? It is for the bottom level worker, as well as they are going to what? They are going to improve the knowledge, they are going to improve the skill, right? And because of that, training, it is what? It is considered as the continuous process, because each and every work at some sort of time, they are going to what? They are going to require that enhancement of a knowledge, right? Their knowledge need to increase, okay, right? So basically training, that is going to what? That is going to improve the knowledge, the skill of the person, right? In the general terms, we can define training as what? That is, means providing theoretical and practical knowledge with reference to the work of the employees, right? Whatever the work, whatever the task that they are going to perform at their particular department or at the specific time, right, they are going to require training. What is the definition that has been given by the expert, or we can say that the scientific meaning of training, that is, it means give up-to-date information about the organization, that what is the organization is all about, that we have seen in the last step of the selection process, right? That they are going to what? They are going to see about, they are going to give the index and program. They are going to give the information about the organization, their mission, what is the vision of the organization, what kind of work that they are going to perform, how many departments are there, everything that will be stated, right? So training, it is what? They're giving information to the about the organization to increase the efficiency, skill, attitude, aptitude, and technical skill of the employees, right? Their efficiency need to improve. See, I know that, yes, what are the things that I'm going to perform, right? But training, it will give me the more scope, or it will give me the particular, you know, broad concept or a broad idea about the work, or I will learn new things from it, right? And that is why training is going to play a very important role in the organization for the employees, right? And basically training, that is for requirement for whom? That is for the bottom level workers, maximum that bottom level workers, they are going to get the training, right? And it is a continuous process, okay, right? So basically, see, training, it is about what? Okay, yes, in every organization they are going to arrange some sort of a training programs, like related to work. Some training programs, it will be there for the personality development, or some disciplinary training that will also be there, right? That behavior changing training, everything that will be done. And training, it can be done within the organization or outside the organization, right? Some of the organization, you know, they are taking out their employees at a specific place, right, where they can have that, you know, that fun training, like going outside, training program will be conducted, and then they are going to have that particular area where they can what? They can enjoy the particular things, right, at whatever the things that they are going to learn, whatever the skill that they are going to learn, everything that need to be done, Okay, right. So basically, training, it is going to play a very important role, right? Because see, when the training that will be given, the person is going to learn new skill, person can enhance their skill, or we can say that, you know, the technical skill that is going to increase. And due to that, their chances of promotion, that is also going to increase. Okay, yes, I have that knowledge of 30%. With the help of training, I have got that extra knowledge. So now I can go beyond my limitation. Okay, getting my point, right? So next is, what is the importance of training? First, that is modern information. See, training is necessary for what purpose? For that, you know, to enhance the, or to we can say that, you know, that to get up to date information about the technology that is being introduced in the particular business environment, right? Like whenever the technology is going to change, the technological training that will be done, right? We can take example of the current scenario, right? Due to this COVID-19, many of the teachers who are not aware of this particular e-learning, they are being trained. Now they are using that particular thing. So obviously get that modern information that need to be given, so that whenever the new machinery or that new technology that will be introduced, right, by the company, it is easy to use it. Okay, right. Then second, safety. Those who are operating at the machine, those employees, right, by those who are going to handle the big machineries and everything, they are going to get that particular knowledge of that, and how to handle the machine, what are the, if any kind of breakdown that happens in the machine, then what are the steps that they are going to take, right? So ultimately it will reduces the accidents, it will reduces the particular consequences that can waste the particular manpower as well as the machines, right? So safety training that will be given to them, it will improve the safety, or it will increase the chances of safety of the employees, right? Third and important one, that is increase in the job satisfaction. Okay, now understand this thing. When you get training, you know, the you can have the better understanding of the job, that how to perform the job, how you are going to handle the particular manpower that works under you, or how you are going to behave with your co-workers and your superiors, right? And ultimately you will come to know, okay, yes, this thing that I need to perform, each and every idea that you are going to have, right? So ultimately that will increase your enthusiasm, that is the employee's enthusiasm, that is going to increase, and which is in turn increase in the job satisfaction, right? And job satisfaction, once the job satisfaction that has been achieved, obviously the employee is going to stay for a longer period of, right? They are going to work more enthusiastically. They are going to take more interest into the work, right? Because due to training, they will come to know, yes, this task I need to perform, right? And how to handle the machine, how to, that the new machinery, new technology that are being introduced, how they are going to use it, everything that will be there. Okay, getting my point? So that job satisfaction, that is going to increase. Then reduction in the rate of labor turnover. Labor turnover, I have explained you this meaning so many times, right? We can connect this fourth point with the third one. Okay, when, with the help of training, when your skill and your knowledge and that particular technical skill that is going to improve, your job satisfaction ultimately is going to increase. And when your job satisfaction is increasing, ultimately what is going to happen, that in your organization, in the business unit, labor turnover, it is going to reduce, right? The chances of promotion, that is going to be there. Income that can increase with the help of promotion, right? So ultimately labor turnover rate, that is going to reduce. Again, I'm explaining the meaning of labor turnover rate, the number of employees that are leaving the company during a specific period of time, say for 1 year, that is called as a labor turnover rate, right? And labor turnover rate can be reduced with the help of proper training, that is proper knowledge that will be imparted into the particular person, that is employee, right? And this training, it can be on the job or off the job, that is practical knowledge that will be given, or it can be theoretical knowledge that you are sitting in a classroom, sitting in a boardroom, and then they are going to be teach about anything, give it that PPT will be seen, yes, this things you need to improve, right? Then practical knowledge that will be given, okay, by they are working, and at the time of their work they are going to learn the new skills, right? So due to training, chances of a promotion and the increase in the income, that will be there. So obviously the reduction in the labor turnover rate can be seen. Okay, increase in profit, obviously, okay, when your manpower, your employees, right, their productivity is going to increase, ultimately production is going to improve, and the quality of the product, that is also going to improve, that is also going to increase. So what will be the outcome? Is simple, that profit, it can be seen, or we can say that increase in the profit of the business unit, of the business organization, it can be seen. Okay, then reduction in expenses. Okay, understand this thing. For training, some sort of expense that will be done, right? But due to training, wastage of material, that is raw material, can be less. Breakdown of a machinery, it can be less because the person who is handling the machine is well aware with the handling of the machine, right? So obviously what is going to happen, that unnecessary cost, that is going to what? That is going to reduce, right? And quality of the production, that is going to improve. So we can say that, you know, that the cost of the raw material, that is going to be less, plus as well as supervision cost, that is also going to reduce. Why? Because the person, they are already knowing anything. But see, what is the role of a supervisor? That they are going to supervise the work. If any problem is there, then they are going to what? They are going to help them, they are going to guide them, supervisors, right? But if the person, the worker, they are well aware of the working or the particular that things that are there, that they are going to do, that routine function that they are going to do, then obviously supervision, that is not going to be required. So supervision cost, that is also going to reduce, right? Then growth and development of the employee. See, person or the employees, those who are coming into the organization, basically they are going to come for what? They are going to come for their own personal growth, their own personal development. Okay, now when they are going to learn the new skills with the help of training, so obviously their knowledge is going to increase, their skill is going to improve, then their experience that can be that we can have, right? So ultimately the personal growth and the development of the employee can be seen. A person is entering as a worker with the help of training, he has that capability of becoming a supervisor, then again training, promotion, it will be done, and he can be promoted to manager level job, right? So personal growth and development of the employees, it can be seen with the help of training. And other benefits, like, you know, that improves the quality of production, it increases the prestige of the organization, it reduces stress. See, mainly the root cause of stress is what? Many of the employees, they are not aware, they are not having an idea, okay, by what kind of work that they are going to perform. Okay, now here with the help of training, they know, okay, yes, I'm going to enter into the organization, my role is so and so and so, I'm going to start with this particular machine, I will be ending up with this machine and with the help of this production. Okay, so ultimately the stress is going to reduce and prestige of the organization, that is also going to improve. Why? Because the credit worthiness, that is going to improve because of what? Because of the employees, right? When they are going to learn the new skills, obviously they are going to utilize it, and with the help of that, they are going to what? They are going to improve the quality of the production, and ultimately the prestige of the business organization, that is going to improve, because those employees, those who are satisfied, right, they are going to stay for a longer period of time. Okay, then the cooperation that will be created, loyalty, sincerity, enthusiasm of employee, that is also going to increase with the help of proper training. Okay, so these are the importance, right? Now what we can conclude from here, right? Nowadays, you know, many of the organization or business unit, they are going to have that separate training department where some, you know, training professional, it will be there, that knowledgeable person, it will be there. They are going to what? They are going to give training to the newly recruited person, or we can say that those who are existing employees of the company, right? So when the new employees, they are going to be recruited and they are on the, you know, that we can say that on a training period or a training phase, a particular raw material can be wasted. Stipend, that means the return of the services that has been given by the to the training, that suppose I'm entering into the business unit, I will be considered as a trainee, right? I'm not going to get salary, I'm not going to get any kind of wage, I will be getting stipend, which will be very less than the salary, right? The business unit is going to incur this much of a cost, but this process is expensive, right? But the benefit of this training, that will be what? That will be much more than the expenses, right? Training is expensive, but what we can say that the absence of the training, it can be more expensive, right? This sentence, that it can be asked into the Q reason in the 3 marks of a question, right? Okay, but yes, training is expensive, no doubt, right? That we need to, that raw material that need to be done, raw material will be wasted, stipend that need to be given, right? But if no such expenses that are going to be there, and I'm entering and I'm going to handle the machine for the first time, so obviously it can cause the more loss than the particular expenses that is incurred on the training, right? So what we can say, okay, but yes, this expenses that will not be considered, or whatever the amount that has been spending on the training, it will not be considered as the expenditure, but it will be considered as the investment in the business, because whatever the amount that they are investing into me, right, in behind my training, I'm going to give them return, right, with my improved skill, improved knowledge, and particularly I will be working with more enthusiasm, right? Getting my point? Okay, so this is it, right? Go through it. If you have any doubt, ask me. Okay, thank you.